This is example 2. A square pyramid with side of base 40 mm and axis height 65 mm long is resting with its base on HP and one of its base edges is parallel to VP. Develop the outer surface of this pyramid. So here we are having a square pyramid of side 40 and axis 65 and it is resting on HP with its base. So this is going to be a very simple case of a square pyramid directly resting with its base on HP. So the top view will be a square and front view will be a triangle because it is a pyramid. But here one of the edges should be parallel to VP. Okay, that's not an issue. But here it is mentioned develop the outer surface of the pyramid. So these instructions, by reading these instructions, we come to know that this is a question of development of surface. So we will see now first how to imagine this. So on your screen, you have a square pyramid. The bottom base will be of a square shape as we have seen already in the previous sections, as you know. So assume that this square pyramid is hollow. This is not solid. Assume that it is having only the surfaces. I will remove this. So now you can observe that easily. So it is made of, it is like hollow, hollow portion. So what I will do is I will just take out the surfaces in order to show you the how the square pyramid will look when the surface develops. So this is one of the face, triangular face. I am placing it somewhere here. So now you can observe this is the one triangular face. Now I will bring the second face also. And I will bring all the faces in the same plane. They will be together. So now you are easily able to visualize the development of the square pyramid. Only we are taking out the surface from the square pyramid. Just imagine a square pyramid there. And when I take all the faces from the square pyramid, it will look something like this. So on your right hand screen, this is the complete development of square pyramid. Four triangular faces. And we will draw this by radial line method only. We will see now. Because the lines are radial to each other, we will see now how to draw this.
The top view is a square of 40 mm side. This is very simple and we did in the last problem we took one formula theta is equal to 360 into radius by slant head. It's not required here to develop the surface. Just we need to measure this slant height first here, which is actually something around 69. We can just take an arc of length of some portion and there is no fixed rule to take this line here or here everything. You can take anywhere line because you are developing the surface. You can take the first line anywhere. I am just taking it here. But as one side, as this is a square pyramid, we will measure this and we will cut four arcs here. Sorry, one more time. So after that, what you can do is just keep your drafter and join these two points, or else you can take this scale, any scale. This is your point. This has been joined. and now you can easily join this, or otherwise you can first join this point from the apex. This is O dash, and if I mark some points, just to show you, you can show here as 1, 2, 3, 4, which can come anywhere here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and again 1. You see, this point is again 1 because this is the first edge only. If you refold it, if you just fold it above this square pyramid, then this line and this line will be the same line. So, and this completes our exercise number 2. Thank you.
This is the final solution of a square pyramid directly resting with its base on HP, and this is its surface developed. As we know, as we have already seen, the square pyramid will have four triangular faces, and you can see them here. Also, you can draw a square here indicating the bottom base. This base you can also draw here, here, or here, or here, indicating the base of the square pyramid, but here we have just drawn the faces.